First of all, we hear about something called intoeing, and you called it something else.
Pigeon-toed. It's
pigeon-toed.
Yes.
All right. Give me an idea of what that is.
Basically, most adults tend to walk with an out-toed gait of about 15 degrees.
Uh-huh.
And a lot of kids, not all kids, will walk with their toes pointing towards each other, like pigeons. That's what I'm talking about.
Oh, that's right.
There you go. And so, yeah, it's all the... My child walks with their toes pointing together, pigeon-toed, in-toed, they're all the same.
So you said it could start in the thigh bone, the tibia, and or your foot.
Yeah, so any one of the bones of the lower extremity, if they are curved in or twisted, can cause an
in-toe. Which is the most common in children?
So it depends on age.
Okay.
Toddlers or newer kids tend to have more something called tibial torsion, which is a turn in their tibia, which is the bone underneath your knee. Older kids and adolescents will have femoral antiversion, which is a twist in their femur, and both of those cause the intoeing. Metatarsus adductus is less common. There's a fourth place it can come, but it's not mechanical, and that's kids with things like cerebral palsy or other neurologic conditions in which their muscles are imbalanced, and so their muscles are actually pulling their feet in. That's a much, much rarer condition.
But do you need treatment for it? There it is right there. There's a picture of somebody
yep,
with
there
it.
There you go. So for the most part, no, you don't need treatment. A lot of these are physiologic.
way back when.
Right, yeah. So a generation ago or so, as you're alluding to, we
used to... The old dinosaur here, way back when, they put these braces on me. They were huge.
Yes.
Are they called braces?
Yeah, we have we used to use braces for this, absolutely.
And I have a picture of me, and it's like, you see me like...
Like
walking like a tin man.
Yeah, tin exactly. You can sort of people remember Forrest Gump and things like that. Those are the kind of braces that we used to use, and we thought they worked because you put them on the kids, and as they grew, they seemed to get better. But we have pretty good data. We have studies in which we took kids and we split them into braces and not braces, and the rate of recovery was exactly the same. And then we found some kids with the bracing. There's a few problems. There's the social stigma of wearing a brace. If you're wearing a brace in school, kids can be mean.
Yes.
And then number two, we found some of those kids with hip weakness and quad weakness and that kind of stuff. And so we really don't use bracing anymore.